Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on contractile proteins. Now, before I start this presentation lecture, I would like to show you some of the body's skeletal muscles. So here you can see the muscles of the head and neck region are shown. And this is just for our information. You don't have to remember all these names, but just you look at the muscles. Okay, then these are the muscles of the trunk, and the muscles are shown in the anterior view. So you just look at the muscles, various skeletal muscles of our body. Then muscles of the trunk, posterior view. Okay. Then superficial muscles of the upper limb. Superficial muscles of the lower limb. Now, as you know, we have already studied this structure of skeletal muscle. If you remember, 6 months ago, I have delivered the lecture on the skeletal muscle. So here, once again, we are revising some of our concept regarding the skeletal muscle. Here, you see in the thigh, the muscle is shown, and that muscle is shown over here. So here we can see what actually the muscles are made up of. So these are all the bundle of fascicle. So individual skeletal muscle, we can say it is made up of many fascicles, and all these fascicles, they are covered by connective tissue layer, that is epimysium. Okay, now here they have shown one fascicle, and what these fascicles are made up of. So here you see the muscle fiber. So we can say the fascicle is made up of many muscle fiber, and this one is the muscle fiber. And muscle fiber, they are made up of myofibril. So inside we can see many myofibril, and one myofibril they are showing us. So we from the bundle of many myofibril, they have snatched one myofibril out, and we are viewing it. Okay, and now over here, so this myofibril, when we zoom, it look like this, and now we are further zooming this myofibril. So myofibril are made up of myofilament. Myofilament means protein. So here the muscle is shown in the relaxed state, and this is the muscle. They are when the contracted muscles are contracted in left hand side figure. So you have the idea about sarcomere, the distance between two Z line, then the A band, then the I band. A band, we know, made up of myosin protein. I band, there is the actin protein is present. Then this figure, entire skeletal muscle, connective tissue, upper myosin, perimysium, then fascicle bundle here. Then all the names, myofibril, You see the myofibril are shown, then blood capillary, muscle fiber, okay. Then anisotropic or A band, Z disc, M line, isotropic band, M line, Z disc, tropomyosin, thin filament, actin, thick filament, myosin head. So this is the entire skeletal muscle they have shown in the figure, okay. Now here in this figure, three basic type of muscle: smooth muscle, cardiac muscle, and striated muscle, okay. And these are the morphological form of muscle. You just have a look at this muscle. You don't have to remember all this name. These are the forms of muscle. And here you see, here one muscle is shown and the fascicle. So the bundle of fascicles are shown, and all the fascicle together they are covered up by the epimysium, okay. And you can see on the fascicle again connective tissue layer is present. That connective tissue layer is known as perimysium. So this fascicle is shown over here, and the fascicle is made up of muscle fiber. So on the surface of muscle fiber, the connective tissue which is present, that is known as the endomysium. Now this muscle fiber is made up of myofibril. So myofibril is shown over here in sarcomere, okay, edge zone. Now the myofilaments, so here they are showing separately myofilament protein, myosin and actin, okay. And here the individual myosin molecule is shown. So in the myosin molecule, there is L meromyosin and H meromyosin are shown. So we are going to discuss all this thing in this lecture, okay. Structure of myosin, structure of actin, okay. Now here, this is just for your revision purpose, okay. We are revising the things. The skeletal muscle is made up of connective tissue, muscle fascicle, blood vessel and nerves. And muscle fibers, they are present in muscle fascicle, or we can say muscle fascicle, they are made up of muscle fibers. Then muscle fibers means the cells of muscle. Now in the muscle fiber, sarcolemma, sarcoplasm and many nuclei are present, okay. Then myofibril, mitochondria, glycogen granule. And this myofibril, they are made up of this all this proteins, okay. Now we are starting our presentation lecture on the muscle protein, but rather we should focus on the contractile protein, because there are many muscle protein. For example, over here you see alpha actinin, desmin, integrin, okay, gamma actin, titin, nebulin. So you don't have to prepare about this muscle protein or the structural proteins of the muscle, because in your syllabus you need to prepare the contractile protein, okay. So myofibril, they are made up of three kind of protein. First one is the contractile proteins. Now this contractile protein, they are generating force during the muscle contraction. Second type of protein, they are the regulatory protein. And this regulatory protein, they are acting like a switch. So they are making the muscle contraction process on and off, okay. Then the third type of protein are the structural protein, and this structural protein, as I have shown you earlier in this figure, okay, in the previous figure that I have shown you right now. So this structural protein are the protein which keep thick and thin filament in proper alignment. So they are keeping the thick and thin filament in their original places, okay. So the thin and thick filament cannot displace from their original place. That is the meaning of this thing. And this structural protein, they also provide the myofibril, the elasticity and the extensibility. So the myofibril, the proteins, they can easily contract and relax, and if required they can stretch or they can be elongated. That is the meaning of this thing. And structural protein, they link the myofibril to the plasma membrane, that is the sarcolemma, and with the extracellular matrix. Okay, so over here in the first point, you don't have to remember this point number 3. Only first and second you need to remember. Now moving forward on second point, here you see the sarcomere is shown, okay, and in this figure A band is shown, edge zone is shown, M line is shown, I band shown, okay, then Z disc is shown. Now all this we have discussed in the lecture on skeletal muscle, and here you see in the I band, okay, so in the I band only the actin protein are present, then edge zone, so edge zone only myosin protein present, then the M line where the myosin protein are going to anchor, see myosin molecule, they are going to anchor on this M line, okay. Then A band, you see the A band, so actin and myosin, thin and thick filament, they are overlapping each other in A band. And see, you see this arrangement, and key is written, okay. So myosin, and blue color is used for myosin and red color is used for actin, okay. So blue color, let's say the thick filament, and the red color thin filament. So the thick filament is surrounded by 6 thin filament, okay, or we can say myosin is surrounded by 6 actin. That way, if you want, you can understand, okay. And this is the three-dimensional figure, so you need to understand they are showing the cross section, okay. And here muscles, in this figure muscle is relaxed, and what happened to sarcomere when the muscles are contracted? So you can see the difference in the figure, okay. Now we are starting today's lecture. So the second point, see, contractile protein in muscle are the myosin and actin. So these are the two contractile protein that are present in our skeletal muscle. Now the components of thick and thin filament, they are thick filament, in thick filament myosin protein is present, and in thin filament actin protein is present. Now myosin is the main component of thick filament, and myosin function as motor protein, okay, in all three type of muscle tissue, that is the cardiac, smooth and skeletal. So in all three type of muscle tissue, this myosin acting as the motor protein. Now what are the function of motor protein? So this motor protein, they pull various cellular structure, so that the achievement of the movement is possible. And how this movement of our body organ is possible is that the ATP is hydrolyzed, so the energy is released. So we can say the chemical energy which is present in the ATP is converted into mechanical energy of motion. So there is a production of force, and due to this force, this protein, motor protein, they are able to move our body tissues and body organ. So by that way, they are able to produce a force on our body system, and finally our entire body can be in the motion. Okay, so the movement is possible due to this motor proteins. So in the muscle contraction topic, you will learn how this entire mechanism is happening. Okay, so in muscle contraction we will discuss this thing, so how the force is produced. Now moving on the third point, see, in the skeletal muscle, about 300 molecule of myosin form a single thick filament. So here in the figure, this one is the thick filament is shown, okay, and in the structure of this thick filament, there present the 300 molecule of myosin, okay, and this one is the myosin molecule. So this is the thick filament, and thick filament is made up of about 300 myosin molecule, and this one is the myosin molecule. Now each myosin molecule, the shape of molecule, this one we are discussing the shape of myosin molecule. So as you can see, the shape of myosin molecule is like a two golf club, and they are twisted to each other. For example, this one, let's say this one is one golf club, okay, but in the golf club the handle is straight, but over here the handle, they have twisted to each other, okay. So the shape of the, so here we are remembering that the shape of each myosin molecule is like a golf club, and there are two golf club which are twisted together, okay. Now this figure is important for you, so I am showing you this entire figure. Now moving on to the fifth point of our discussion. Now the myosin tail of the myosin points toward the M line in the center of the sarcomere. So here you see, these are all, for example, this is the myosin molecule. Okay, this entire myosin molecule, and the tail part, you see where the tail part is present. For example, this one is the myosin molecule, so you see the tail part, this one myosin molecule, tail part, okay, myosin molecule, tail part. So tail part, so the tail anchors into the M line, okay. So this is the fifth point. Now moving on the sixth point of our discussion. Now the tail of neighboring myosin molecule lie parallel to one another and forming the shaft of the thick filament. For example, this is the myosin molecule, and this is the tail, myosin molecule, tail, myosin molecule, tail, Here also Marcion molecule tail, Marcion molecule tail, Marcion molecule tail. So all this tail together they are forming. So this is this we can say this is the this one is the shaft of the thick filament. So what is shaft? What is the shaft? Tails of neighboring Marcion molecule lie parallel to one another and they are forming the shaft. So this entire portion, this portion, we can say this is the shaft, or this is also, this is the shaft, this one is the shaft, shaft, okay. Now, on each Marcion molecule, two projections are present, and we can compare this projection with the golf club head. And this projection on Marcion molecule are known as the Marcion head. So here in this figure, see this one and this one, these are the two projection, and these two projection are known as the Marcion head. Now each Marcion head has two binding side, one is known as the actin binding side and second one is the ATP binding side. So in the figure I am showing you, so this is the actin binding side and this one is the actin binding side, this is the ATP binding side and this one is the ATP binding side. So the Marcion molecule with this actin binding side going to bind with actin, and over here ATP molecule, this place ATP molecule is going to join and ATP is going to hydrolyze, okay. So ATP binding site also function as an ATPase enzyme, and this ATPase enzyme hydrolyze ATP, and this hydrolyzed ATP they generate the energy, and this energy is utilized for the muscle contraction. So this entire mechanism we are going to study in the lecture of muscle contraction, how the ATP is hydrolyzed, how ATP is joining to this ATPase enzyme, and how it is providing energy and how the muscles are contracting, okay. So this is our theory point, seventh point, and this is the figure. Now moving on the eighth point of our discussion. Now the head of Marcion molecule, it is projecting outward. Over here you can see this one, this head, okay, and this head is enlarged over here. And here we can see that the head is projecting outward from the shaft. So this is the shaft, and the head is so many tails together they are forming the shaft, and we know that head is projecting outward, okay, from the shaft in a spiraling fashion. So here you can see this entire portion is projecting outward in a spiraling fashion, and this point, one of the six thin filament that's around each thick filament. So this thing I told you that you remember, and in the cross section we have seen that one thick filament over here, you see this is the this one is the thick filament, this purple color, and these are the thin filament. But here since this is the 2D, okay, we are viewing this muscle in the 2D, so that's why we can see that the thick filament is surrounded by only two, but actually when you see the figure in three dimension like this way, then you will realize the one thick filament is surrounded by six thin filament, okay. So this is the ultrastructure of muscle, okay. Now moving on the ninth point of our discussion. Now we are starting the discussion on thin filament actin protein. Okay. Now initially the actin is present in the form of monomer, and many actin monomer they join together and they form the actin filament, and this filament is in the form of helix. So two filament twist together and form the helical form. So what they are saying is, for example, here the actin protein, so the monomer, as you can see, these are the globular protein, and the G actin is in the spherical form. So all this G actin, they join together, that means they are polymerizing, okay? And once the G actins are polymerized, so here you see this one is the one filament, and this one is the second filament. So there are two filament and they are twisted to each other and they are forming the F actin. Okay, so F actin is in a twisted helical form. Now on each actin molecule, on the surface of each actin molecule, there present a myosin binding site, and on this binding site myosin head is going to attach during muscle contraction. So in the figure I will show you. So here you see, this yellow color actin filament are shown, and you see this one, all this, okay, these are the myosin binding side, and here at this point the myosin head is going to bind during muscle contraction. So this was the ninth point, okay, and this figure I'm showing you, okay, then this figure. Representation of the thin myofilament. Then portion of a thin filament. Okay. Now, small amount of two regulatory protein, topomyosin and troponin, are also present in thin filament. So we can say this one troponin shown in blue color, and topomyosin, which is covering the myosin binding site on actin. So this topomyosin and troponin, these two are regulatory protein, but we should consider them as the part of thin filament. Okay, so under the thin filament title, these two are also included along with the actin. So thin filament, we can say thin filament is made up of actin, topomyosin and troponin. So that is the meaning of this point. Now moving forward, then point number 11. Now in relaxed muscle. For example, you and me, both of us, okay, now we are sitting on the chair right now, and right now our muscles are relaxed. So what happens in all our skeletal muscle when they are not contracting, we are not moving, or we are sitting at one place, or our body is in the relaxed state, or let's say we are sleeping, that time what happens in our skeletal muscle? The myosin is not permitted to join with the actin. So myosin is blocked to join or to bind with the actin. And how this happens? Why myosin in relaxed condition cannot join the actin? So here you see the topomyosin protein. And if you observe carefully, see, one actin subunit is shown over here, and this one is the binding site for myosin head, okay? But in the relaxed state, what happens? The tropomyosin, this sky blue color protein over here, is covering the myosin binding site. Okay, so since myosin binding site on actin subunit is covered by tropomyosin protein, so myosin head, okay, this myosin head, okay, cannot join with the actin active site. Okay, so that is the meaning of this point. And topomyosin strand, they are held in place in the resting condition. They remain on this, they are covering in relaxed condition, they are covering the myosin binding site, and this happens with the help of protein troponin. So together troponin and tropomyosin, they are covering the myosin binding site on actin subunits. Then the now here soon you will learn that when calcium ion Ca twice plus joins to or binds to troponin, then there occurs the conformational or the structural changes in the troponin protein. And once the structure or the conformation of the troponin protein is changed, what happens? Now the topomyosin moves away from the myosin binding site. And now the binding site is open, so the myosin head can join the myosin head can join the myosin binding site on the actin subunit, and now the muscle contraction can proceed. Okay, so this is when we are contracting the muscle, and this is when the Ca twice plus calcium ion binds with the troponin protein. Okay, so now I am showing you this figure. Now here in this figure, okay, you see troponin, then the topomyosin, and myosin binding site. So myosin binding site on actin subunit is covered by topomyosin. So the myosin head cannot join over here in relaxed condition. And here you see active site for myosin, or we can say myosin binding site. Actin subunits are shown. So you see this figure. Now we are discussing the muscle filament, and here we are discussing about the thick filament. First we are going to discuss the thick filament, and then we are discussing the thin filament. Now thick filament, they are made up of myosin protein, and this myosin protein, they are having the large molecular weight, and in the structure of myosin protein they are present 6 polypeptide chain. Among this 6 polypeptide chain which are present in the structure of myosin, one pair means two heavy chain, and two pair means 4 light chain are present. So here the thick filament myosin molecule is shown, and you see in the structure one pair, that means two heavy chain are present, and they are twisted to each other, and there are two pair, that means 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 pair of light chain are present in the structure of thick filament. Okay, so in the structure of myosin molecule, one pair of heavy chain and two pair of light chain are present. Now most of the heavy chain myosin has alpha helical structure. So alpha helical means both the chain they are twisted to each other, and they are in the form of alpha helical. So both the chain, they coil to each other, and this heavy chain, this coiled alpha helical structure heavy chain, they are forming the tail of myosin molecule. So here in the figure you see the tail is shown, this one is the tail, and it is made up of two heavy chains. Okay, now the 4 light chain and the end terminus of each heavy chain forming 2 globular head on myosin molecule. So these are two chain twisted together, and this is N terminal, this one is N terminal. So this N and N terminal of heavy chain, and 1, 2, 3, 4 light chain. So once again, N terminus, N means, we know in the structure of protein the N terminus means where the amino group is present. Okay, that end is known as N terminus. So N terminus and this four light chain, they are forming two head of myosin molecule. Now this head, we know, we have already seen that the myosin head, they are having two sides. One side is for binding with the actin, and second side is where the ADP is going to bind. So there are two regions, one is actin binding side, and second region is acting as the myosin ATPase, and in that the ADP is hydrolyzed and energy is released, cross bridge is formed between actin and myosin. So this is about the thick filament. Okay, now we are discussing the thin filament. We have discussed this. So now once again, initially the actin is in the monomeric form. So the monomeric form is known as the G actin, and this G actin is actually in a globular form. Okay, so it is the rounded or the circular protein. In that form it is present, and we know this many G actin, they join each other. That means the G actin, they are polymerizing, okay, and two helicals are formed, okay, two chains are formed, two strands are formed, and these two strands, they are twisted to each other. So the alpha helical structure of actin is formed, and this alpha helical structure, which is in the filamentous form or the filamentous actin, is known as the F actin. So here in the figure you see, here earlier these were all G actin, and all this G actin, they have combined to, or they have polymerized, and they have formed the filamentous form of actin. So this you see is the F actin, and this is the alpha helical structure of actin protein, F actin. Now actin, on the actin subunit, let's say this one is the actin subunit. So here there is the myosin binding site, and on this myosin binding site, the myosin head attaches, okay, or the myosin head binds when the muscle, they are contracting. Now when the muscle are not contracting, that time what happened, the myosin binding site is covered by protein tropomyosin, okay. So as the tropomyosin is covering the myosin binding site on actin, the actin and myosin cannot bind to each other, okay. So they cannot interact. And now we are discussing about this component, troponin protein. So before that, let's discuss few things about tropomyosin. So tropomyosin, as you have seen in the figure, is a filamentous protein, and it is present in the groove of each twisted actin filament. So it is covering all the myosin binding site on actin filament at rest, okay. So this tropomyosin is blocking the joining or the binding between actin and myosin. That is the meaning of this tropomyosin. And when we want to walk or we want to exercise, so that means we are contracting our muscle. So contraction to occur, this tropomyosin protein must be moved away from the myosin binding site on actin subunit. So the cross bridge between the actin and myosin can be formed, okay. Now we are discussing the troponin, okay. Now what is troponin? So troponin is a complex of three globular protein. In the structure of troponin, three globular proteins are present: troponin T, troponin I, and troponin C. And on the this troponin, they are present on the entire length of the tropomyosin. So let's say here one troponin is shown. So after few distance away, second troponin is present, then the third. So that way they are saying, okay, so few distance apart on tropomyosin, these troponins are present. Okay, now troponin T, and T stands for topomyosin. Now what is the function, what the role this troponin T is playing? So troponin T is attaches the troponin complex to tropomyosin. So we can say with the troponin T, the other two component, they are joining. For example, this C, troponin C and troponin I, they join with troponin T, and this troponin T joins with tropomyosin. Okay, then troponin I stand for I for inhibition. So what this troponin I is doing? So this troponin I along with the tropomyosin is inhibiting, is preventing the interaction between actin and myosin. So troponin along with tropomyosin covers the myosin binding site on actin. So this is the role this troponin I is playing. Okay, and now let's discuss about the troponin C. Okay, now C stands for calcium ion. So C for Ca twice plus ion. Now when this calcium ion, they bind to troponin C, what happened? Some structural changes or the conformational changes occur in the structure of troponin protein. So when these changes are occurring in the structure of troponin protein, okay, now what happened? See, now the intracellular, that means let's say the cytoplasm of muscle cell, the concentration of Ca twice plus when increase, so this increased concentration, due to the increased concentration of Ca twice plus, this Ca twice plus ions, they bind to troponin C. Okay, and once this calcium ion bind to troponin C, there occurs the conformational changes or the structural changes in the entire troponin complex, and due to this conformational changes, this tropomyosin is move away from the myosin binding site. Okay, so now on the actin subunit, the myosin binding site is open, and now the myosin head can join with the actin subunit. Okay, so this is the role this troponins are playing. Okay, each one is having the individual role. Okay, now we have reached to the final stage of our discussion. Now here in this figure, see figure 2.32, okay, schematic diagram showing the structural organization. See over here, this one 2.3.3 myosin molecule. Okay, so here you see the myosin molecule is shown, and which are the structure or the molecule that are present in the structure of myosin molecule, that you need to see over here. Okay, so you see the tail and you see the head part, you see the light chain. Okay, now one more thing I would like to add over here. Now as you can see on the screen here, this one is the myosin molecule, And now we are digesting this myosin molecule with the enzyme trypsin. So when trypsin digests myosin molecule, then we are having two fragments. So when trypsin digests myosin molecule, there forms the two fragments. One fragment is known as heavy myosin, and the other fragment is known as light myosin, LMM. Okay, so now we are having two fragments, HMM and LMM. Now here, as you can see, this LMM is present in the tail portion of the myosin molecule, and this LMM is not having ATPase activity. That means this LMM cannot hydrolyze ATP, and this LMM cannot bind to actin. Okay. So this thing we are keeping in mind, and here this part, this is the heavy myosin, so it is having the globular head, and some part of tail is also present in this heavy myosin HMM. Now when we digest this HMM with the enzyme papain, so this HMM is further digested into two fragments. So this two new fragments, they are HMM S1 and HMM S2. Now this HMM S2 is the fibrous form, and again this is not having ATPase activity. ATP cannot hydrolyze by this HMM S2, and this HMM S2 cannot bind with the actin. So this part cannot bind with the actin. Now here, this globular head, HMM S1, heavy myosin S1, the head, globular head, is having ATPase activity. ATP can be hydrolyzed, and this head can also bind to the actin. Okay, so this thing we are keeping in mind, and see this much information, this part, this part, then this information. Okay, and this figure. Okay. This figure, and this is the, this we have discussed, okay, myosin molecule. So here you see in the tail two heavy chain twisted each other, alpha helical form, the head, N-terminus of heavy chain in the head, and four light chain, two pair of light chain. So this is the myosin molecule. So with this, we have completed this presentation lecture on contractile proteins. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation lecture, and I also hope that this presentation lecture will be helpful in your exam preparation and also in your studies. My name is Manish Koshti, sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye-bye. Namaste.